Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to the Web Application Penetration Testing and Secure Coding. This is video number 10 and in this video, we will see get and post method. First, let's look at our connection right now. We are using VirtualBox to host the two machines, Kali Linux and Ubuntu. The Kali Linux will be our attacker machine. The Ubuntu will be our vulnerable application machine. In the previous videos, we have installed XAMPP and by installing XAMPP, we have installed Apache, MySQL, PHP, etc. So currently this is our configuration looking right now. Now let's check connection first. Open your VirtualBox, select the Kali Linux, go to the settings and make sure the network adapter is connected to the NAT, vulnerable applications machine, go to the settings and make sure vulnerable applications network adapter is also connected to the NAT. Then start both the machines. Now this is my attacker machine, Kali Linux. Let's check its IP address by typing ifconfig. Its IP address is 192.168.109.157. Let's go to our Ubuntu machine. This is our Ubuntu machine. Let's check its IP address. Okay, its IP address is 192.168.109.158. Now let's ping 192.168.109.158 from our attacker machine. Okay, go here, ping 192.168.109.158. Okay, the ping is successful. That means we can connect to the vulnerable applications machine. Now in the vulnerable applications machine, make sure Apache web server is running. Go to your attacker machine, go to the browser, type IP address for your vulnerable application virtual machine. Okay, the connection is successful. Now instead of typing IP address each and every time, what I'm going to do, I'm going to give a domain name to this IP address. So we are going to give vulnerable.app as a domain name to this IP address. So we don't need to enter this IP again and again. We can just enter vulnerable.app. Just remember one thing, this is my IP address. Your IP address might be different. So first make sure to check your IP addresses. Okay, we'll open terminal. After that, using vim, we can go to the /etc/host. In that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to insert my vulnerable applications machine's IP, that is 192.168.109.158. After that, press tab on your keyboard and type domain name vulnerable.app. So this IP address will be mapped with your domain. Make sure you enter your machine's IP address. This is my machine's IP address. Let's save this. You can use Vim, Nano or any other your choice of editor and you can do the setting. Let's test the domain. Go to your browser, type vulnerable.app. Okay, it is connected. So make sure you do this setting. So now we don't need to enter IP here. We can just enter vulnerable.app. This is my attacker machine and this is my vulnerable applications machine. My attacker machine's IP is 192.168.109.157. My vulnerable application machine's IP is 192.168.109.158. And we have given a domain vulnerable.app to the vulnerable applications machine. In this video, we are going to see get and post method. Let's first start with the get method. Now, this is our code for get and post method. This is the same HTML code as the last one, but there is only one difference. In the form, there is new attribute method equals get. Let's see the result of this page from our attacker machine. And if you want to download this code, I'll give the GitHub download link in the description box below. Okay, this is the web page. Let's enter some information here. Full name Vikram. Let's select gender male and click on submit. Okay, this is the server's script. It is returning the data which we passed to it. And as we can see, the data which we passed is displayed into the address bar, such as full name equals Vikram and gender equals male. So in that code, the method was get. So when there is a get method, the form data is appended to the URL. Now let's test this once again using the burp. Connect the burp. Start burp. Now if you want to know how to set up a burp and etc, you can check my video on burp. I'll give the link in the I button above. Okay, let's send some information. Vikram, gender is male. Click on submit. Okay, it is saying connecting. That means the request is in the burp. And as we can see, the method is get and it is sending full name and gender from the URL. Let's click on the forward and this is the response from a web server. Click a forward and now response is into the browser. Let's go back into the vulnerable machines. Let's change the method to the post. Save it. Now let's go to the attacker machine. This is the same web page. Let's enter the information. Full name Vikram, gender male, press submit. As we can see, the script on a server side got the data, but the data is not into the URL. That means post does not send data from the URL. Let's confirm that using a Bob proxy. Let's turn on the intercept. It is on. Let's enter full name. After that, enter gender male, click on submit. It is saying connecting. That means the request is here. Now see the difference here. Instead of get, the request is now post, and we don't see any data appended into the URL. So this is how the browser is sending data to the web server, not from the URL but from the body. So this was the difference between the get and post. So never send any sensitive data using the get. So that's it for this video. If you have any suggestions, any feedbacks, then please mail me on vikram@vmaskers.com. Thank you.